Good morning. Welcome back to the old Polish farm. Got some snow overnight. I think it started snowing about 7 o'clock last night. And didn't stick, though. Had freezing temperatures overnight. But it's March now. And I think, and I don't normally do this, kind of stay away from the menus, the game menus, in this series, just to kind of help with the immersion a little bit. But we're going to take a look at the crop calendar real quick. Oop, we need to go up to the top. No, wait, there we go. So we can see we are in the planting window for wheat, barley, oat, sugar beet, sugar cane, cotton, grapes. And if you keep going down, olives, poplar, grass, and oilseed radish. Oilseed radish has me thinking, man, I should have maybe put oilseed radish in the field we're going to put the corn in to get us that fertilizer state, like I did for the field that we want to put the wheat in. I could still do it, I suppose. I don't know. Not sure it's something I want to do. I got other stuff I want to get done. Actually, I need to check the contracts too. See if maybe there's additional work. There we go. There's a little bit of frost on the ground still. I mean, the temperatures were freezing overnight. It was good and cold. I'm surprised that it didn't stay cold longer. It's warmed up quite a bit. We're supposed to get some rain, I think, sometime today, but I don't know what time. Actually, if we can do that, we can look at the weather forecast as well. It's overcast, but looks nice. Let's take a look at that. So yeah, we're up to 10C, whatever that is. Okay, so we're looking at rain around 2 o'clock this afternoon, and raining most of the rest of the afternoon. So we got this morning to work, really. So we should not dilly-dally too much. We're gonna use the Z-Tor for the seeding. We still got some seed left. I think there's some in there too. We're kind of light on filling it with seed when we used it last time, because we didn't want it to be too heavy. I don't think that'll be a problem with this tractor though. Close enough to the seed to, there we go. Fill it about halfway. Okay, cool. closer to 60%. That's okay. Since it's still... Yeah, it's not that cold. I was gonna say, since it's still cold, I'm gonna close the door. Interested to see how soon wheat is ready to. This guy sucks. Can't tell where I'm seeding. Not really. Sorry, I was having a mental breakdown for the ridge marker, top one, now one and up. I guess you can't see it. I could not see it from behind it though. I was not seeing where we were shooting. sat up. I was trying to go along the edge, make sure I got the edge, and I was going to come back over there a little bit, and really messed that up. Alright. I might be just a little bit right here to get a little deceived. I'm going to pull up field info and take a look at it. I wonder if weeds are going to go in this field. I'm not sure why there aren't. Yeah, we got weeds now. So yeah, that's something we're gonna have to take care of too. All right, so the roller. I don't know if we'll need the drawbar on this tractor like we did on the other one. Try it without. We might be able to get away without it. Go around the outside. Tried to raise it. Only works going forwards. It should get all the way out to the edge. Well, I guess with the other one we were struggling with. Yeah, it'd be better if I had the drawbar. I need the drawbar. After we get down to the bottom. careful with it. More careful with it, though, because it'll kick over pretty quickly. Field info up, so it appears rolled. Or the map looks any different. I'll look at it quick. It appears rolled. Yeah, I think having the drawbar. Helps with the maneuverability of it. Sometimes maybe even a little too much. Certainly did with the other tractor. The older Vitor. I'm wondering if I have the time now, Maybe I should put oilseed radish in the field that we want to plant corn in. Think about that a second. So yeah, I think I'm just gonna go ahead and put oilseed radish in that field too. It'll save us the cost. I'll just go in and come in from the other side and drive across the field we just seeded. It'll save the cost of mineral fertilizer by giving us that first stage of fertilization. What I am interested to see, and I'm not sure exactly how that would work, is I wonder if the fact that we put the oilseed radish in and then have to cultivate it in, if that will override the fact that we plowed the field, which would prevent us from having weeds. So I'm not sure what would happen there. But I guess it'd be a good learning point, because if we get weeds, that means we have to run over it with a weeder. Also, oh, I don't want that. I hope I didn't put anything in. I gotta change it to oilseed radish. I don't know what I'm doing here. There we go. I meant to turn the seeder off. Off. I'm not going straight, am I? That's what I get when I try and give you good angles. I just don't see what I'm doing. Should pull up the mini map so I have the azimuth there. Look better. Put in a couple of handlings so I don't have to drive on the field we just seeded with spring wheat. Maybe if I back out, give myself a little more perspective on what's going on. So this, I'm not sure how quickly this will grow. But we're March 1 now, so I think it ought to grow by April 1, which is when we want to plant corn. I think we should be fine. This is going to take a little longer than the other field, so we'll have a little bit more length in the time lapse. I think the last couple of time lapses have only been about 30 seconds long. Each. I think he would actually come in and do the headlands last. I'm not sure. one of you farmers can tell me, how would you do this properly? Would you come in and do the headlands at the end? I think that's correct. I think we're ready to cue the music. I was turning around over by the greenhouse over there. I realized that, we probably could start our vegetables in there. I think I got everything. So, yeah, I'm going to check the weather. And if we're not going to drop below freezing again, I'll go ahead and do that. Let me double check, make sure the field's all good here. Growing. Oh my goodness. We might get 100% yield bonus because we did sugar beets before this, and I think it leaves a fertilizing state on there. Ooh, I wonder if it'll stack, if the oilseed radish will stack on top of that. No, that's not right. That's not right, is it? I don't think so. All right, let's check the weather. Well, we really can't see out far enough. Oh, there's the lows. The low on March 2 is going to be 10°C, which we know is 50 degrees from our earlier math our earlier math problem. So let's go take this back, and then let's go see if we can figure out where to borrow some water. Let's go back this way. This way you can turn in by the water right here. I don't think we can get to this though. It's got like the guards all the way around it, looks like. So there's another one the other way. Go look over there. Get to it from there. Oh, that thing's completely got guards around the whole thing. there. I forgot, this tractor's a little louder. I need to talk louder when I'm driving it. But it's all right. So my water tank is, or my liquids tank, because this is probably what we're going to have to transport milk in later. Hopefully we'll get all the water out of it. Otherwise, might have to put in that government drain mod. I don't know what the capacity for water is on that greenhouse. We'll put one tank in it. I think I saw the pond over here, and I think I can get to it at a field entrance on the backside, so we're going to borrow water there. Wow, crops growing in a lot of the field over here. This bank is gonna be. Hey, it was working. That's interesting. So I have like the realistic trailer weights thing on. I did not know that it would do that with liquid. Waters, we're not going to be able to carry much milk at all, are we? Well, let's see how much we have. We might just fill this up and go into the dairy. Oh, man. Come on, dude. Traffic. It's rush hour here in Colonia around lunchtime. What time was it going to rain? 2 o'clock, I think. I was going to see if anybody needed any work done. Couple of phone calls. Do that after we get this over there. Get the greenhouse going. Try and stay out the field as much as possible. I thought you have to drive over it with a weeder, aren't I? Listen, I don't need to be so careful. I'm gonna try just for fun. Hmm. There we go. Let's back up to the water tanks just for appearance's sake. But this will give us an idea how much water it'll hold, too. I don't know how quickly it'll... Small greenhouse made of windows. There we go. So what should we do? Let's do tomatoes, and let's do lettuce. Let's just do vegetables. We'll leave the strawberries alone. And then, there we go, nice. That was quick. And then let's go get another tank of water. And then we'll call that good. We'll keep an eye on it. But we want it to stop in the winter time, so we don't want to keep it too full. Since we're expecting rain the rest of the day, we'll probably just go ahead and end the episode after we get this water in the greenhouse. So I'd like to thank you for hanging out with me here today at the old Polish farm. You have a choice of how you spend your time, and I appreciate that you chose to spend a little bit of it with me. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope that you come back. And visit us again here at the old Polish farm in Colonia, Poland. Where things are looking up. Camera. Just keep it going. We'll let it ride. Again, thanks for watching.